This video updates previous videos covering the Material Theme Builder plugin. You can find the links in the description. So what is the Material Theme Builder? The Material Theme Builder is built to assist in exploring the possibilities of Material 3's dynamic color or build a custom material theme. To make use of the web version of the Material Theme Builder, you can simply visit m3.material.io/theme-builder. And here I can visualize dynamic color by selecting the example wallpapers. That will give me a preview of my assets and screens. And I can also upload my own wallpaper and add extended colors. And it's also possible to toggle between light and dark mode. If I switch to custom, here I can build a custom theme by changing the core colors. You can use the color picker to adjust the color, and the algorithm behind dynamic color is built with HCT color space, that's Euchroma and Tone. And the Material 3 theme will have a light scheme, a dark scheme, tonal palettes, I can also add my extended colors. So if I want a semantic color, maybe something orange. And call it warning. I can rename it as well. And that will show up here with the light, dark theme and the tonal palette. And once I've configured my theme, I simply head on over to the export menu and I can export the Material 3 theme. Alternatively, the Figma plugin can be used. So if you have a blank document under resources, plugins, search for the Material Theme Builder plugin and run the plugin. And if it's your first time running the plugin, we'll have the option to create a theme. As you can see in the properties panel on the right, there are no styles. Here I can select to generate my textiles, generate state values, which will be needed for M3 kit. So I've ticked that. And now we have an option to color match, which is good if you need to adhere to brand guidelines. And in this example, I've ticked all the checkboxes. However, this will depend on your use case. The older version of the plugin generated the schematics and type scale. This no longer seems to be an option. Once I select create theme, this will generate the baseline material theme styles and tokens. Alternatively, if you go to the Figma community page of the Material Theme Builder plugin, by selecting playground file, that will generate the color schematics for you. And if I launch the plugin again, just run the plugin, it will show the material theme. And using the plugin, you can upload an image, change the source color or seed color for dynamic color. It's also now possible to choose the image source to be content instead of wallpaper. So if I select this button that will randomize the source color or seed color, I can also input my color by selecting that using the color picker to insert a hex color, Euchroma or tone. And I can see I have color match selected there. And when I'm ready, I can select update and that will update my material theme. And once that's run, I can see that my material theme is updated. I can also add a new theme. I go in there, add new theme, or import a theme. And as we've shown before. You can also add extended colors, so I can add a semantic color, call it warning, rename save, and I can also choose to turn on harmonization. And that will automatically update once that's generated. It will be visible under color styles, it's extended colors. However, it won't be visible on the playground file. As mentioned, it's also easier to update older themes. So if I load the plugin again, Material Theme Builder, and this is the Neogenix Design System Figma file that I have open. It's detected my old Material three schemes that were generated with the older version of the plugin. However, I will need to hit update to update my styles. So if I head on over to, for example, this sign in mockup, sign in page mockup, before I toggle the swap or color mode swap, I'm just going to hit update first. And once that's updated, I can simply hit swap. And that will swap the theme for me. And I can do the same for the rest. I can also toggle between light and dark mode, choose a contrast, medium contrast, and I can do the same for the rest. So I simply hit swap, and I can repeat it for the next theme. So I'll just hit swap. Right, and just as with the web version, you can export from the export menu. Alternatively, you can also export your designs to no code web publishing solutions like Webflow, or using the Figma to HTML with Framer plugin, which you can find by searching the Figma community.